Here's your custody exchange expense tracker. You can use it by yourself or link accounts with your co-parent to use it with them. Under this bell, you'll get notified of changes they make. Adjust your account settings to be notified by email or on your phone as well. Now I'm going to enter a new expense. In this case, it's a cell phone bill. It's helpful to assign a category to each expense. You can choose from one you've used before or create a new one. The app remembers how parents split a category, so you'll only need to enter a percentage once per category. And if you override it, it remembers the new one. Now I can see how much the other parent owes for this item, Nora's monthly cell phone bill. Click here if this is a recurring expense so you won't have to enter it in the future. Just select when it should stop recurring here. I can add attachments, maybe a receipt or a picture of the item, and then when I'm ready, I hit save. Here's the expense I just entered. Entering a repayment is similar. In this case, Jamie paid Susan $37.50. You can enter a new payment method in the box or just choose an existing one like this. A reference number is helpful if there may be questions. Down here, you can apply the money to certain expenses. Any amount you don't assign will go towards the oldest expenses first. To edit or delete an entry you created, click any part of it that's blue. Then make changes or hit delete on the next screen. You cannot edit an entry your co-parent made, but you can refuse to pay it like I'm doing. You can also mark when your co-parent refuses to pay. If one of you did not receive a repayment as entered, you can mark that like this. The homepage displays expenses and repayments, then the current total owed. Below that, you see any expenses rejected or repayments not received. To focus on fewer entries, you can filter by category and date range. The unpaid filter works great for invoicing. I'm going to filter for expenses from last month. To print or export what shows up, click the printer. Here you can choose whether to include expenses that don't affect the total owed. You can save this report as a Word document or PDF or print it. Attached images come at the end. If you've linked with your lawyer, they can create and print these reports for you. Now you know how to track parenting expenses in Custody Exchange. If you have questions, visit custodyexchange.com/help or contact us in the app.